हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई नो यू मस्ट हैव सीन योर ओल्ड फोटोग्राफ्स। लुकिंग एट ओल्ड फोटोग्राफ्स ब्रिंग्स बैक मेमोरीज एंड मेक्स यू फील नॉस्टैल्जिक। बियॉन्ड इट वी कैन ब्रिंग इन रश ऑफ वेरियस इमोशंस। व्हाट मे बी सच इमोशंस यू एक्सपीरियंस आफ्टर सीइंग वन ऑफ योर ओल्ड फोटोग्राफ्स। व्हेन यू सी योर फोटोग्राफ्स यू हैव डिफरेंट रिएक्शंस। व्हेन यू लाइक योर फोटोग्राफ यू से वाव इट्स वंडरफुल। समटाइम You just laugh at it. You may surprise at your old pic when it is unbelievable. You feel disgusting when you don't like it. Sometimes past memories make you cry also. Such reactions over the nostalgic thought make me welcome you on AduLearn to learn a very beautiful poem. Name of the poem is A Photograph, penned by the poet Shirley Tolson, prescribed in the syllabus of CBSE Subject English, Class 11th, Book Hornbill. A Photograph is composed by Shirley Tolson. So the first, let's try to know about the poet. Shirley Tolson was born on 20th May 1924 in Hanley on Thames in England and passed away on 15th May 2014. She took up writing as a career and served as the editor for many magazines. She was greatly influenced by her father Douglas Horsfall Dixon, who himself was a poet. She was passionate about creative writing. Under the influence of Celtic Christianity, she has penned two major works, Celtic Alternative in 1987 and Celtic Year in 1993. Not much is known about the publication history of A Photograph. Still, it is a very popular poem by Shirley Tolson. The poet talks about a photograph in this poem. It is the photograph of poet's mother when she was 12 years old. Two cousins of her mother, Dolly and Betty, are also in the photograph. The photograph was clicked by her uncle. One day, the poet found the same old photograph of her mother after her death, and she started to miss her mother. Let's know about the background of the poem. The poem is in the emotional tone. The poet as a speaker expresses her emotions about her mother. It is in the nostalgic mood. The poet remembers her mother by looking at her photograph. The poet has paid a great tribute to her mother by composing this beautiful poem. Mutability is the theme of the poem. Growing, aging, fragility, and finally death is the bitter realities of life that should be accepted silently. This poem is set in the memories of two women, the poet and her mother. Poet's mother reminisces her childhood, seeing her childhood photographs. The poet reminisces her mother after her death. The poem is written in blank verse. The poem depicts three stages. The first stage is associated with the childhood of the poet's mother, when she went to the sea beach with her cousin enjoying holidays and when the photograph was captured by her uncle. The second stage is associated with the youth of her mother when she saw the photograph after 20 and 30 years later. She reminisced her childhood days. She laughed a lot seeing her photograph. The third stage is the after death stage of her mother. After the death of poet's mother, the poet reminisced her mother's laugh. Now we will learn the poem stanza-wise. Stanza first of the poem. The cardboard shows me how it was when the two girl cousins went paddling, each one holding one of my mother's hands, and she, the big girl, some 12 years or so, all three stood still to smile through their hair at the uncle with the camera. Paragraph paraphrase of the first stanza of the poem. Cardboard here refers to the photograph of the poet's mother and two of her cousins. This is a childhood photograph of poet's mother. Photograph was taken when she went to sea for paddling with her cousins. Each of them was holding one of hands. The poet's mother was the eldest of three, some 12 years at the time. Her uncle captured the childhood memory with his camera. He captured the photograph of three silently smiling faces through their hair. In this stanza, there are three important points. Number one, description of childhood photographs of poet's mother and her two cousins. Second, this photograph was taken by her mother's uncle. Third, they are laughing in photograph. Glossary words, cardboard means photograph here. Paddling means walking or standing in shallow water. Literary devices. There are two literary devices used in this stanza, alliteration and allusion. Alliteration is the repetition of the same consonant sound. In line, all three stood still to smile through their hair. There is the repetition of sa and tha sound. Allusion is a literary device in which an object or situation is used to give indirect reference of something. Here, cardboard's lack of durability shows the impermanence of human life. Second stanza of the poem, a sweet face, my mother's, that was before I was born, and the sea, which appears to have changed less, was their terribly transient feet. Paraphrase of the second stanza of the poem. Since the photograph was clicked much before the birth of the poet and when her mother was of 12 years old, so her face was very sweet. In photograph, poet's mother and both of her cousins are standing at the beach. So the sea, a symbol of perennial characteristic of nature, seems to wash the feet of all the three girls who are subject to decay. It depicts that nature is everlasting but human beings are perishable. Here there are three important points. Number one, her mother's face was sweet before poet's birth. Number two, the sea is still same, seems washing their feet. Number three, poet's mother is no more now. Glossary used in this stanza, terribly means extremely, transient means mortal. Two literary devices are used in this stanza, alliteration, in line, their terribly transient feet, there is the repetition of T sound. Second literary device is synecdoche. Synecdoche is a literary device in which a part is made to represent the whole or vice versa. Here transient feet is used not only to describe the transient feet, but actually it represents the transient life of human being. Stanza third of the poem, some 20-30 years later, should laugh at the snapshot. See, Betty and Dolly, should say, and look how they dressed us for the beach. The sea holiday was her past, mine is her laughter. Both rive with the labored ease of loss. Paraphrase of the third stanza of the poem. After a lapse of time, say some 20 or 30 years later, the poet's mother would laugh at the photograph. As it revived the pleasures of her childhood days, she spent at the sea beach. She would also feel amused at the way how their parents had dressed them up for the beach. Now both are in great loss. The mother has lost her pleasurable childhood days when she went for paddling, and the poet has lost the laughter of her mother as she is no more. Now both of them are trying to overcome the loss, accepting the reality of life. Here there are four important points. Number one, after 20 or 30 years later, poet's mother saw her childhood photographs. Number two, she would laugh at the photograph. Number three, now the poet and her mother both are in great loss. Number four, both are trying to overcome the loss. glossary used in this stanza. Snapshot means photo. Rye means disappointed. Ease means comfort. Literary device used in this stanza is oxymoron. An oxymoron is a literary device containing words that seem contradict each other. In the sentence, both rye with the labored ease of loss. Labored and ease are opposite words used together to describe the same entity, loss. Fourth stanza of the poem. Now she has been dead nearly as many years as that girl lived, and of this circumstance there is nothing to say at all. Its silence silences. Paraphrase of the fourth stanza of the poem. The poet is in melancholic mood while depicts about the death of her mother some 12 years ago. The circumstance, that is the death of her mother, overwhelms the poet with such intense emotion that she is speechless. To express her sense of pain and loss, the silence of death seems to prevail, and this silence seems to silence all other thoughts. Here there are two important points. Number one, the poet's mother died 12 years ago. Her death made the poet quite silent. Glossary used in this stanza is circumstance means situation. Literary devices, here there are two literary devices used. Number one, alliteration. Number two, personification. Alliteration is in the line, its silence silences, because there is a repetition of sa sound. Personification occurs when a thing or abstraction is represented as a person. Here the circumstance has been given the human quality of silence, so there is personification. At last, takeaway from the poem. Objects of nature are perennial and everlasting, but human life is transitory and gets distorted with time. So we should accept the reality of perishable life with absolute ease. Thank you for watching it till the end.